Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Begin on the ground with Akers. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Stafford. And he's got this to Jefferson. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. It's a gain of 35. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Off the fake to Akers. Here's Stafford. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. On third down, Stafford. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They'll run on first down with Akers. Had a nice move, but can't break away. Down just inside the 30. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. Play action, Stafford. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. From the gun, here's Stafford. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
They snap it to Stafford. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
So just a tremendous play there defensively on this opening drive, not just to make the interception, but to take it all the way home.
And it felt like this was a defense that was on its heels a bit to start this thing off.
Yeah, they pretty much let the other guys march right down the field until that moment.
Yeah, key play there. Turned it all around. Big moment.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Oh, trying to gauge the sun, and he muffs it. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Stafford here, coming off his pick six. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner, okay? All right, on this one. But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing his way.
The benefits could be great. You throw it to a great receiver, he could come down with it anyway.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. That's the NFL vet, Calais Campbell, coming in and dragging him down. Fourth down, so what is the punter, Riley Dixon? Good open field tackling there. A 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at the 34. And they'll run the option to start the drive. And some room to work. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown.
Well, we've certainly seen this before, CD. No one can quite electrify a crowd like Lamar Jackson. Really don't know what else to say other than that was special right there.
I think you pretty much said it all, but I go back to what you said about electrifying a crowd. He's also electrifying us, and we're calling the game. This guy is simply sensational.
Tucker with the extra point, and it's now 14 to nothing. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
It's almost human nature, isn't it? They score on one play, you come out on offense, you try and do exactly the same thing. They tried the deep ball, couldn't quite connect, but give him an A for effort.
And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage.
Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Chuck Clark in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down.
Well, someone is certainly having a big game, and while that sack doesn't quite have the splash of his pick six from earlier, you know he's thrilled to be making big plays during a great individual effort today.
14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Riley Dixon now to punt it away. Said and done, it's a 58-yard punt.
And they will take over first and 10.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Bateman's got it on the crossing route here. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. On first and 10, it's Dobbins. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Jackson from the shotgun. And it's caught. Touchdown.
Devin Duvernay.
A 13-yard touchdown.
And the Ravens take a 3-touchdown lead.
Kicker, he looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught at the 5, and he gets in. But no one was expecting a fake there, but they add 2 more onto their lead. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
And they'll start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
Well, CD, you kind of feel like they're in a bit of a danger zone right here because now you're down 3 scores, and I know we're in the first half, but the way this offense hasn't been able to generate anything, you feel like they probably need to get something going on this drive, right?
Yeah, and sometimes I overuse that this is an important possession. But I think this has to be the possession where they come up with an answer because only a few teams in league history have ever come back from a 4-score deficit. If they don't score here, that's what they could be facing the next time they get the ball.
From the gun on third down, Stafford. Trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
I mean, at this point, CD, what is not going their way in this first half? After that pick six, they now have a 4-possession lead here.
And that allows them to say to themselves, how about we get everybody involved, okay? Because this one is a runaway. And it's looking like it's going to be even more of a runaway. Everybody gets a chance to play and get a little bit of love. The more guys they get to watch in the highlight reels from this one, the better.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago and threw the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go-around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
They'll fake the give. Now Stafford. And quickly, he just gets that ball out of there. Not quite sure what he was doing, and here comes the flag.
Yeah, he hadn't gotten far enough away from the pocket to throw that football away, and that draws the flag.
Yeah, the old tackle box, right? Get outside of each tackle, and then you can go ahead and throw it away, and you're in good shape. But if you're back there in the pocket.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Chuck Clark in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning. Here's Riley Dixon now as he's on to punt for L.A. And from their own end zone, it's a fake. And this is caught. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. A big breakdown defensively there on the fake punt. Turns into a huge play and a first down. They'll fake it. Now Stafford.
A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Well, this defense is certainly organized and playing off of each other because the rush is providing pressure and the coverage is forcing incompletions and capitalizing on mistakes. When you get every level on defense hitting at once, you get first half scores just like this one.
And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. On second and 11 now, Stafford.
And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Here's Stafford. And able to find Higbee. It's complete.
And he's going to have the first down as they move into field goal range here at the 25-yard line.
Stafford. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Again, it's Stafford. Flushed out right.
On Stafford for the third time is intercepted.
Picked off by Kyle Fuller.
And the Ravens are going to take over once again with a football at their own 20-yard line.
Now, I'm not sure that the wheels, Charles, are coming completely off, but they're shaking a little bit. That's three interceptions and now interceptions here on back-to-back drives.
And I think about what a Hall of Fame coach told me that he always told his teams. When a mistake happens, just move on to the next play. Let it go. Hard to do when you're throwing this many interceptions. That's exactly the attitude that has to be adopted.
Operating from the 27 now. Here's second and three.
Off the play fake to Dobbins. Here's Jackson.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and it's going to be a first down. Well done. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by David Long,
and he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half.
So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
Final adjustments being made for the second half. Whether they'll amount to much in a game that's already pretty well decided, well, that's another question. Nevertheless, let's get you back out to Brandon and Charles.
And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach. We can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
They go play action with Jackson.
That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Here's the option, running right. And he stopped immediately there. Throwing on second down, Jackson. A slant route caught by Bateman. And in for the Ravens' touchdown. Rashawn Bateman on the touchdown throw from Lamar Jackson. And the Ravens just continue to roll. And they'll try to run it in with Dobbins.
And he is not going to get to the goal line. And for the first time here this afternoon, they are thwarted on the two-point conversion.
To party alter ego. Killed your leader in gazebo, did it for the people. Love what motivated, I did not do it for hatred. But I truly hate the devil, I cannot debate or fake it. I was asked a question and the asker thought it hard. If I was facing death and I could ask one thing of God, I would ask for every to be free here and abroad. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God. Truthfully, we envy, so why we so envious? And why our own kind envy us? Mark said it's hard, but we gotta keep our head up. Going even though we know we fed up. It's hell attention, plus we ain't careful where we all pay attention. I need all my real soldiers on the front line.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Superdome in downtown New Orleans.
Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Dallas Cowboys and the New Orleans Saints. The kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans.
On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone.
And a less than desirable return as he's out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
Over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
Play one and Prescott to the air. That's into a crowd and intercepted.
Marcus May with a pick. And they'll be at the 18-yard line. Great field position here in the red zone.
Wow, just one snap in, Parker, and the complexion of this game has already changed because for the defensive side, they just handed their offense a short field and a big early advantage. And even though it's only the first snap of the game, we're going to look back on this one and see if it has lasting effects as this game moves on.
And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second and three.
Looking left side, that's caught by Landry. And he's brought down. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. Kamara is in. Touchdown, New Orleans. They go high formation. Fullback leads the way for the touchdown. Sort of a lost start, isn't it?
It really is, but sometimes when you're able to bring it back and use it against other teams, they're not prepared for it. They haven't seen it in a while, and now you gain an advantage, and we just saw that advantage result in a touchdown.
Well, lots on for the point after. Good as the Saints have a 7-0 lead. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. In trouble, and the ball's out. It's in the end zone, loose. And he'll score. Touchdown.